I'm Marla Barnes, publisher of the Hydro Group for Penwell, and here are this week's Hydro headlines. Starting off in Vietnam this week, the safety of the dam at the Song Tran 2 hydroelectric complex is still in question after increased seismic activity has rattled the structure in the past months. A recent report by the Vietnam Union of Scientific and Technology Associations have found that earthquakes, including one that registered 4.2 on the Richter scale, have caused water to run inside the dam. The leaks have caused concrete movement inside the dam, creating a dangerous threat if not corrected soon. Moving now to Chile. Austria's Strabag has won a $490 million contract for tunneling and construction work at the two-powerhouse 531-megawatt Alto Mapo project. Under the contract, Strabag is to design and build more than 46 kilometers of tunnels and shafts by drilling, blasting, and boring with tunnel machines. Strabag says the work will take about 18 months and should begin immediately. Now in the United States, the U.S. Department of the Interior has begun what it's calling a high-flow experimental release at Arizona's Glen Canyon Dam. The release is part of a new long-term protocol introduced by Secretary of the Interior Ken Salazar earlier this year, which seeks to use the high-release flows to rebuild shorelines and improve fish habitats. The release will last nearly 5 days and will reach more than 42,000 cubic feet per second. Other releases are expected to continue through 2020. And last this week, it's been several months since we first unveiled the new HydroWorld.com. And even though we think the redesigned site makes it better than ever, we've added a number of new features to improve it even further. You might have noticed our new Business Transactions and Transitions section on the homepage. It's already become a popular section of the site. And we've added a new virtual tour that better describes the benefits of our premium content subscription service. We've also revamped our Facebook and Twitter feeds, as well as updating our Apple and Android mobile applications, better known as mobile apps, to better provide you with all the latest hydro news when you're on the go. If you have any questions or suggestions about these new features, let us know. We'd like to hear from you. Well, that's the hydropower news for this week. Watch for this newscast each and every week, brought to you by Hydro Consulting and Maintenance Services.